Joining us now, actually back on the program after a long time away, an Academy Award nominee for his work in Winter Bone. I mean, we could go through all the credits. We'll do a little bit, you know. Deadwood, Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. The list goes on. Everest. I mean, he's been in so many things that we've enjoyed, and now he's got a new movie out called End of Sentence, which I watched last night. Please welcome back to the program, John Hawks. John, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
We're great. We're excited to talk to you. I know you were on the show with me before Stephanie joined about 10 years ago. I can't remember what it was, but couldn't wait to talk to you again. So thanks a lot for doing this, man.
Oh, my pleasure. How are you doing there?
We're doing good. Everybody's good. We're going to do a little fanboy here. I don't know how much fangirl, but you're one of my favorite actors. And I'm going to try and get through this quick, but because I watched the movie last night, and I really want to talk about that. But I like you in a lot of the things that other people don't remember, and one of them is Eastbound and Down. And I think when you were on before, we talked about that. That's one of my all-time favorite shows, and I know people like to talk about Winter's Bone and Deadwood and stuff like that, but for me, that's my John Hawks right there.
Oh, well, you got a twisted sense of humor, my friend. That's good. I respect that.
Stephanie, is he right or wrong?
It's accurate,
it's
yes.
It's accurate.
What's that, sir?
Now, see, as Mike was going to try to get through this as quickly as possible, I'm going to let this linger.
No, come on. We don't have
to. No, just for like a second, because Saul was one of my favorite characters in Deadwood.
Yeah.
100% hands down. And I don't feel like we got enough time to really sort of sit with him. You know, we had a lot of other characters. I think, you know, all the whoring and boozing and murder was what a lot of people spent their time with. But I just absolutely loved you.
Oh, thank you so kindly. It was so great to do the movie. That was after all those years of after the show canceled, it was great to wrap it all up. So I'm glad people liked that.
Well, we're here with John Hawks. The new movie is End of Sentence. End of Sentence. I always want to say End of the Innocence because it's a Don Henley song, but it's End of Sentence.
Right.
Now, John Hawks.
It's not like a courtroom drama, but it's not.
No, it's not. Although there is a lot of trial and tribulation, I will say that. But John Hawks,
there are trials
and tribulations. John Hawks, for people who don't realize it, is an actor's actor, and I watch you work, and I think here's a guy you would never want to tell a secret to, because there's no way John Hawks or whatever character he's playing can tell a secret because it's written all over his face from the moment we see you sitting outside the prison.
I guess that's a compliment.
It is. It is. My first thought was, what's wrong with this guy? What is eating this guy? And, you know, this could be called End of Penance or End of Recompense. I mean, it could have a lot of different titles because of what we find out in this movie. And, I mean, it's so smooth, man. It's such a beautiful movie. You know, your character Frank and Sean and Jewel, of course, Sarah Bolger and Logan Lerman. First of all,
both really terrific in the movie. Yeah, it takes place in Ireland, and it's kind of a fish out of water story of a father and son who don't get along much at all, and they're tasked with delivering Frank's wife and my character and Logan Lerman's character Sean. They've got to deliver some ashes to a lake in Ireland, and there's a lot of comedy in there too, but yeah, it's got a lot to say about people, I think.
We're here with John Hawks. The movie is End of Sentence. You got to see this movie. And you know, it's funny when I mentioned what's eating this guy, and I felt like you were playing one of those characters, and you were, who sort of took it on the chin a lot and maybe acquiesced a little bit. And then when we get to the point, I don't want to give too much away, where he starts questioning whether or not his wife was faithful even before they met, then I realized what it was. It was a situation where his whole life, your character's the whole life, he couldn't please anyone. His father, he felt like he didn't really come through for his wife and obviously his son. And boy, does that carry through. I mean, you just do it beautifully.
Yeah, well, it's relatable, I think. It's a very human thing. I think that feeling you described. Yeah.
And I'm doing like a Chris Farley interviewing Paul McCartney. Wow, remember that scene? That was great. But no, I don't want to give too much away. But at the end, let me just say that it was so poignant when you guys are standing at the lake, and you couldn't let her go. Once you found out what she was really up to, it's like you had your hands together. I don't want to give it away too much because then people will know. But it was like you couldn't let her go.
Mm. Yeah, it's interesting you saw that. That's certainly, I think, a lot of what the character was feeling and what I was trying to portray. So that's good.
Wow.
Don't pat yourself on the back, Mike, all right?
Listen,
jeez, he's so proud of himself
right now.
It
was a movie that really came to me. I really enjoyed it, but I enjoy your work, so it was easy for that reason. John Hawks is here with us. End of Sentence, definitely a must-see. Find it, obviously, you know, with the situation now, it's video on demand and things like that. John, there's so many other things we could talk to you about, your music, some of the other things, but we ask, I don't know, he's an Academy Award nominee, Stephanie. Can we ask him the question we like to ask
Go
people?
Go for it, yes.
All right, well, you know, you've been working a long time, but sometimes we like to find out movie stars if they've ever been left speechless by meeting another movie star or celebrity. Could be an athlete or just some famous person, a Supreme Court justice, for instance, or whatever it happens to be. And we sort of position it by, we had David Spade on a while back, and he said he was at a party at a house, and he was standing in line waiting for the bathroom, and Paul McCartney was standing in front of him, and he was just speechless. Did that happen to you, like, early in your career, or does it still happen?
Yeah, well, right when I moved to Los Angeles in 1990, I was grocery shopping, and you know, on a related note, Ringo Starr was pushing his cart down an aisle, and I actually turned around and went back to make sure. I didn't say anything to him, but he smiled, and that's quite a moment. You know, there's a person who changed the world, who's seen a lot of different things in his life, and that was thrilling. Oddly, you know, I'm a book reader. I like reading books, and so I've met a couple of authors along the way, not super famous people, but Doris Kearns Goodwin. He's an author who writes a lot of historical fiction. When I was working on Lincoln, the movie with that Steven Spielberg directed, I got to meet her, and I was strangely, nervous, excited to meet her. Yeah, she's a terrific writer. So it's funny, you know, who ties our tongue.
Yes, and especially when you're already famous and it's happening to you. People are meeting
people
you.
People are like, oh my God, that's John Hawks. Oh my God, that's John Hawks.
That's what I would do.
I would absolutely do that 100%.
That doesn't happen a lot, but I'm glad it does. That's good.
Well, listen, John, we're so glad you took the time. We can't wait to have you back on again and talk about other things that you're doing. But, man, End of Sentences.
Hey, can I really quickly plug? Just you can find the music if you're interested.
There.
At Bandcamp. Rodney and John is the band. I mean, Rodney and John at Bandcamp.com.
Got it.
Wow, it sounds like fun. Go to Bandcamp with Rodney and John. I like that.
That's where our music is. Thanks a lot.
No, thank you. End of Sentence, folks. You got to watch this movie. It's beautiful. John Hawks, everybody. Thanks, John.
Thank you.